stories more remarkable than the story of creation? Awesome. To witness the forming of new land. If a site were to be coveted, this would be the one. And in a land as picturesque as it is majestic, rugged as it is enduring, patient as it is long-suffering, the Caribbean island of Montserrat, where nature is reenacting the wonderful crafting of new mountains, plains, and valleys, where geography blends the illusion of size and space to contradict every Puritan mathematical deduction of actual dimensions, mankind is offered a glimpse into a most alluring mystery of nature. These islands, where did they come from? What was their origin? Consider three major mountain ranges, each precisely positioned by some previous volcanic eruption, with perfect proportioning, creating the illusion of expansive grandeur. An intimately interwoven pattern of hills, mountains, valleys, and colors. A natural wonder. Montserrat simply refuses to be ignored, especially now. Once again, 500 years after Christopher Columbus named it for its imposing topography, forever picturesque, Montserrat is still captivating us, redefining itself, reshaping its lines, expanding its boundaries. To its people, Montserrat's volcano in the Soufriere Hills is both friend and foe, destroyer and creator, uncontrollable but admirable, and craving admiration from us all. Its story attracts students, professionals, artists, artisans, and workers from every walk of life. It makes one reflect. Power, dignity, and magnificence. This is the evidence of creation in progress. Ironically, it is largely to these massive volcanic mountains with their intricate network of valleys and deep ravines in what, after all, is a physical space 11 miles long and 7 miles wide that the people of Montserrat owe the peace they enjoy with their volcano. This ruggedness rendered unnecessary the evacuation of the small island, even in the face of one of the most spectacular eruptions of our time. It was safety first when the volcano erupted in 1995, and after 14 years, it is still safety first. Geographical analysis soon established that the risk from adverse volcanic events here in the north of Montserrat actually placed it below 1 in a million. But Plymouth, the ancient capital, that's something else. It has to be seen to be believed. Just incredible. A modern-day Pompeii. So much so that it is now an irresistible magnet for visitors with new attractions. Plymouth, Delta, Smoldering Dome, and others, all of which can be safely viewed from designated vantage points. Further south, entire villages were completely obliterated. All this and more happened, but warning was given and total evacuation of the area completed in good time. By the time nature was ready to make its move on Plymouth, Montserrat and Britain had established the best volcano observatory in the world. That Montserrat sleeps free of worry night after night is due in large measure to the sophisticated volcano monitoring conducted here. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 and a quarter days per year. This place never sleeps. The millions worldwide who watched on television as the Soufriere Hills eruption peaked in 1997 would have retained something of a sense of awe at the magnificence of so great a spectacle. No hazard as fearsome as that of an exploding volcano can help but leave lasting impressions. No other volcanic eruption had ever been so closely observed as this one. Scientists around the world now attribute to it a better understanding of eruptive processes than they ever had before. The wonders of nature are for all to enjoy. This one is as accessible as it can possibly be. Numerous people from near and far regularly come to share the exceptional Soufriere Hills experience. They would never have set eyes on so unusual a phenomenon as the intimate association of nature's destructiveness and creativeness without their visit to this island. Awesome, indeed. To be able to enjoy it, to marvel at it,